There is a hadith that the mu'min in every way or form, in every situation, is in the situation of khair, goodness. If we look at our lives, we have ups and downs, we have problems and issues, difficulties, debts, and thousands of different types of conditions that confront us in life. And the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that there's khair, there's goodness, even in problematic times. What khair is this? What goodness is this that Allah Ta'ala gives to the mu'min? That khair is that whatever conditions befall a mu'min or confront a mu'min, there's khair in those situations, that due to that difficulty, Allah Ta'ala elevates the status of that mu'min. And when that person goes back to Allah, then eventually, ultimately, everybody has to return to Allah, our Lord. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, Allah Ta'ala says. So when Allah Ta'ala says that when I create the conditions for mu'min problems, difficulties, ups and downs, then he shouldn't fear or become afraid. He may have more difficulties, more problems, more issues, more difficulties. But the mu'min, the believer, alhamdulillah, for him it is khair, goodness. Khair, as I stated, that he will get the compensation and the reward for that difficulty in Jannah, high status. Allah wants to elevate that person to a higher level, to a higher status. So for taking that person to the high status, it's not due to his ibadah or worship, but Allah Ta'ala makes him occupied and busy with issues. And the second point with regards to khair, goodness, is that there are ups and downs, problems come, worries come in life, difficulties come. But the barakah of those issues is that, praise be to Allah, alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the effects of the effects of those conditions, they don't permanently affect that person. For example, very big point there, for example, somebody is affected by black magic, and the effects of that black magic won't permanently stay with that person. Allah Ta'ala will from somewhere or other create such a solution that Allah Ta'ala will annihilate and eliminate the effects of that difficulty, of that problem. And somehow Allah Ta'ala will eliminate that problem, that issue. Or if somebody is immersed or surrounded by problems, Allah Ta'ala then makes that person strong and protected, that the effects of that issue do not affect that person. That's why in every way or form, in every scenario, there's khair in problems, and a Muslim should not fear or worry, because Allah has given him iman. And Allah has given a big example here, hatta, to this extent that when the ruh of the mu'min is being extracted, even in that is there is khair. Allahu Akbar. The biggest difficulty, the biggest challenge in a person's life is at the time of death, at the time of maut. And the most severe time in the life of a person is maut, death. All the problems and difficulties that come in a life, they are not an atom's weight compared to the person's pain and difficulty at the time of death. So the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stated that even at the time of death, the mu'min is in the condition of khair, in the scenario of khair. We need to understand this point. Further, Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, what's the reason that the person at the time of death is in the position of khair, goodness? What's the reason? There's a reason for this reason, because the mu'min is doing the dhikr of Allah at that time. Subhanallah, what a great, great point. And the mufassireen have stated that this is such a clear, clear point. It has been stated that the mu'min, he'll definitely do his dhikr. Dhikr at the time, the glory, the status of a mu'min is that he will never be negligent of the dhikr of Allah. The mu'min, the believer, he will remember Allah. يَذْكُرُ اللَّهُ كُلْ عَيَانِ. Hazrat Aisha Sadiqa radiallahu ta'ala stated that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's blessed habit of doing dhikr was يَذْكُرُ اللَّهُ كُلْ عَيَانِ. In other words, no moment, no second, no breath would pass in which the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not doing dhikr of Allah. So all of these habits, because the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam shared these with the Sahaba, the noble companions, so all the companions were like this, that they were immersed and busy and occupied in the dhikr of Allah. Always their hearts were busy in doing the dhikr of Allah. Always. And all of those habits, great habits, came from the Sahaba Ikram, shared to the Tabi'een, the next generation, and they had all these habits and characteristics. Then the Tabi'een, they shared these and taught these to the Taba Tabi'een, the third generation, and this carried on till today, this current. And if anybody saw a Sahabi, he became Tabi'i, and if somebody saw a Tabi, he became a Taba Tabi'een, and he became a great individual in the world. And these Safar, these qualities, they continued from the Tabi'een, Taba Tabi'een to the Awliya Allah. And you will not see any Wali of Allah in the world. If he's a Wali of Allah, he'll be the friend of Allah. And he'll be a true Zakir of Allah. A true person who remembers Allah. It cannot be that he's a Wali and he's not doing the Dhikr of Allah. He's laid down a condition. The Holy Prophet laid down a condition. That the mu'min is that person who does the Dhikr of Allah. Who remembers Allah. And with the barakah of dhikr, with the blessings of dhikr done by a mu'min, the Holy Prophet said that his whole life becomes khayr. Goodness, his whole life becomes goodness, problems, issues, worries, on both sides. That due to the barakah, on one hand, Allah Ta'ala says the mu'min does dhikr, so the effects of worries do not affect that person in any way or form, in no way or form. And those things are written in our qism of destiny, they will come. But if he's a dhakir, a man or a woman or brother or sister, then he will come out of all of the problems. He'll get reward, and I will take the person out of the predicaments. And what, due to what barakah? Say loudly, dhikr of Allah. So should we do dhikr or not, my friends? Yes. So we shouldn't be lazy. That's our loss. Yeah. Number one, if we don't do dhikr, then we won't be included in the list of the mu'mins. And we'll realize at that time when we have maut, death, that how much deen, how much deen is left the person, how many days are left the person eats, he's healthy, strong, then he becomes ill. And when he becomes ill, he can't even say subhanallah. But now we've got health, Allah's given us time, everything. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the health, Allah's ni'mas, the favors are great. And the greatest ni'mah that Allah has given is health, good health. And the biggest way to be thankful, the greatest way to be thankful for health, and then if we are thankful, who should we thank for? For our health. So when we wake up in the morning, we should be grateful for our health. Because if you have health, you can do ibadah. If you have health, you can read Quran. If you have health, you can go to the masjid. If you don't have health, how will you go to the masjid? If you have flu, a cold, person says, oh, I'm weak now, can't go. He's hearing the adhan, he's hearing the iqama, masjid is close by. And the sneezes prevent him from going to the masjid. Yes, and the fever doesn't let him go to the masjid. If Allah has given health, vitality, food 2 times a day, and the stomach's filled with the food, Allah gives mashroob and drinks, and drinks coke and 7-up and cold drinks, fizzy drinks and tea at home. What great ni'mas. Health and food and drink is all present, and we don't do dhikr of Allah. Even then, I remember my Hazrat, my Sheikh, 4 days he was hungry, he was severely ill. How many days? 4 days Hazrat Sahib had not eaten or drank anything. And on top of this, the doctors had, the Murideen had said, Hazrat, please take rest. And Hazrat, soon as Adhan would be called, he would get up in his Hujra's room, he would wrap the blanket around him. They said, Hazrat, you are dizzy, you can't get up, you're weak. And you should rest. It's jai for you, permissible for you not to go to the masjid. We'll join you here in the hujra and we can pray here. And look at the answer of the wali of Allah. He said, what are you saying? Hazrat Sahib said, that I eat the ni'mas of Allah and I don't do the dhikr of Allah. That, subhanAllah, what ni'mah did Hazrat Sahib eat? He didn't have food for 4 days. That the poor soul, Hazrat Sahib, for 4 days he was hungry. Look what Allah Ta'ala has given to us, my friends. Yes, Allah has given us ease and comfort and health. Our teeth work, our stomachs work, our fingers work. In this age, in old age, look, someone 60 years, 70 years, we come to the masjid, to the house of Allah, and we don't do dhikr of Allah. We don't do dhikr of Allah. A big loss, massive loss. And there's such a big hadith, a person who doesn't believe, who doesn't remember Allah, he's out of the list of mu'mins. And he who remembers Allah, the mu'min, the person who remembers Allah, who does the dhikr, he gets the status of a mu'min, he gets the reward from Allah, and Allah Ta'ala takes all the problems out of his life. All the problems. Tell me, is this not the case? So my brothers, negligence, laziness, and being unaware of Allah, this has no link with the mu'min's life. So at least minimum, what should we do? Is that for some time, 10, 15 minutes, taking you out of your day, your routine, and the greatest action, the dhikr of Allah, do that. That the highest form of dhikr that the Prophet ﷺ has prescribed to us, which is the dhikr of the heart, maraqabah, dhikr of the heart, qalbi dhikr, yes, silent dhikr. This is a massive action, easy, and the highest in level, that when a person sits and does dhikr of Allah, closes his eyes and remembers Allah in his heart, he starts to do dhikr of the heart, Allah announces amongst his angels, all of you step back, he's remembering me in his heart, I also remember him in the same way. Allah Ta'ala finishes the gathering at that time amongst angels. Allah says that he is now out of majlis, he's detached from the dunya now, he's remembering me in his heart, because the heart is for Allah. Allah announces that he is now detached from the dunya, totally is free from the dunya now, his ruh is detached, he's closed his eyes, focused on his heart, and that's my home. So all of you go away now, angels, I don't need you now. Now it's between me and my servant, Allah Ta'ala says. Maraqaba. Which we, even if we do this for this much amount of time, that in the morning, after Fajr Salah, same place where you prayed, just do 10 minutes maraqaba, close your eyes. Allah, 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 Allah. Focus on the heart. Don't move the tongue. In the heart, the beats of the heart. I'm saying this from my tongue, I'm trying. But don't say from the tongue. Stop your tongue. Say Allah, Allah in your heart, and you'll feel so much satisfaction, and your heart will say Allah, 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 Allah. And you will feel like saying this. In previous days, I told you an event. Somebody I knew, he had an operation. And in Karachi, in Pakistan, open heart surgery he had. And the consultant was doing the surgery. He came out of the operation theater and he went to his wife and children. He said, what good news he must have brought. They were thinking, what news has he brought? He said, this Hazrat, what does he do? What did he used to do in the world? They said, nothing. He's a wali of Allah, pious person. He said, I'm doing the heart operation and his heart is beating. His heart is moving. He's saying, Allah, Allah, Allah. His heart, Allahu Akbar. Allah Ta'ala's statements are truth. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's words are truth. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that when a person dies, even at that time, is khair for that person, because he's doing dhikr of Allah during his life. And due to the dhikr of Allah, his status is being elevated. It's not for nothing, is it? If we don't remember Allah, we should make a promise. 10 minutes in the morning, I'm going to sit down, close my eyes in my home, in the masjid, in the corner of your home. Maraqaba, silent dhikr, silent remembrance of Allah. It's proven from Quran, Hadith, the Walis of Allah, Fazail, Amal. There are so many praises and the mention of from Hazrat Mawlana Zakariya Sahib Rahmatullah about Maraqaba. Read the kitab. Read the 2-3 pages that this is such a great dhikr of Allah that there's no limit to this. There's nothing that can compare to this. So brothers, inshallah, make effort. Read Quran, pray Salah. But this action, Allah Ta'ala said that if you want to become a mu'min, then there's the condition that you need to remember Allah. May Allah Ta'ala give us all the tawfiq and ability. Ameen.